Hey folks, Dagan here from PMTVUK. Today, we have the pleasure of chatting about wireless systems. Why, if you don't already, you should have a wireless system, because they're bloody awesome. And if you already have a wireless, like an older wireless, why you should consider upgrading to one of these wonderful new ones. In this video, I'll be using the brand new Shure glx-d plus system, specifically the glx-d 6 plus. It's a little piece of awesome. Let's get straight into it. Now, I honestly believe the wireless system is one of the greatest things to ever happen to live music in history. Whether it be a wireless guitar system, a handheld microphone, one of those Britney Spears headset microphones, or a lav lapel mic like my little nifty guy right here, the ability to create and perform and have the freedom without being tethered to something is just fantastic. Now, if you're unfamiliar with what a wireless system is, it does what it says on the tin. It transmits a signal from the transmitter, in this case on the guitar, but again, wireless microphones and stuff, into a receiver electronically instead of a cable. Instead of a cable, it gives you the freedom, it gives you the ability to just do whatever you want. Like I say, I'm hopping on for a bit about myself here. I use wireless systems live because I like to run around. I also like using them in the house as well because I hate cables, especially when you sat down. You always wheel your chair over a cable and get stuck around the wheels or whatever, and cats chew cables, I'm very aware of that. So I use wireless systems all the time, so I thought I'd do this little video to show you why you need a wireless system, or if you've got an old one, I'll touch on that, like I said, why you need to upgrade. Now, even these days, there's still a little bit of stigma around wireless systems, whether it be guitar or vocal or whatever, because back in the day, they weren't necessarily great. I'm talking like 70s and 80s here, but that kind of stigma has stuck somewhat. The signal isn't as strong, you don't get the true enough tone through what you're doing, it can cut out, there's latency, you get like police radios and stuff coming through your wireless system. There's a very famous story about Tony Iommi, I think it was Tony or Jimmy Page, having the police radio scanner coming through his stacks on stage. All that's gone now. With the tech these days, the tone is as clear as ever, with no latency. It probably is like 0.0000001 latency, but sorry, quick little side note here for the guys and gals that have never used wirelesses before. Obviously, it's wireless from the transmitter to the receiver. You plug the receiver into whatever you want to. In this case, I'm plugging into the Blackstar St. James 6L6 head. Got a cable going from that into the input. Live, personally, I plug it into the start of my pedal board, then wire the pedal board into the amplifier. Essentially, you just set them up from what you don't want to be tethered from. If that makes sense. I think it does. Kind of does. Anyways, back to why these are awesome. So the tone is just there. So with these new systems, the new digital systems, the glx-d plus, the tone is there and it's better than ever. That's thanks to the fact that this is a digital system. Previously, old systems, which is why they were considered a little bit sucky, they had it wasn't digital, it was analog, which meant that it's getting a bit nerdy now, to transmit an analog signal, had to compress it and then throw it across to the receiver. So you did lose some tone, you lost some sparkle. Not the case anymore with digital stuff. Bloody fantastic. Also, again with the latency, I did mention it was zero, essentially. You can't feel it at all if you think it in your fingertips. If you can feel it, you're a liar and I'll fight you. Some people do prefer cables, and that's fine. It's totally fine, just wireless is fun because you can bugger off camera if you want to. And then come back whenever you feel like. If you were to do that on stage and you were to go away backstage but still want to do a Jimmy Page kind of go away back in the day with the old systems, your signal might get lost, it might get cut out. Not anymore with the digital stuff, with the Shure glx-d stuff. This guy has dual band wireless technology in all the glx-d plus systems, so that scans between 2.4 and 5.8 gigahertz, I believe, which is witchcraft, sound waves in the air and stuff. But that's more than any of the previous ones. So if there is any kind of loss in your signal, if you go behind something or something kind of gets in the way, it will automatically scan within like a millisecond another clean signal. It'll find another clean signal within that bandwidth, and you wouldn't even realize it does it all for you. So you've constantly got the cleanest channel with no dropouts, and the range is absolutely stellar on these systems. You might have already seen the previous video we did testing these out to the max, where we went to a big field and went the other side of a lake to test this out, and the guitar was still coming through loud and clear. It's awesome. Now, speaking of the channels it finds for, you don't mic channels to get the cleanest signal. Previously, on the old analog stuff, I mentioned the radio frequencies from police and ambulances and all that kind of stuff before. that those are wireless signals, analog signals, and you had to buy your own back in the day. So in order to use a wireless, you had to buy, I think it was like £75, you had to buy your own wireless signal for you then to use your guitar or microphone or whatever, and you own that signal. You couldn't stray from it, you had that signal. Not the case anymore, plug in and play with the Shure glx-d Plus. Circling back to the overall tone and tone sucking, if it even does that, it is best to invest in a better quality wireless system like this, just because you're precious over your guitar tone. You're very precious over it. There's already enough going on within amplifiers, within pedal boards and stuff. You don't want anything else to happen to it, so it's best to invest in a slightly better one to preserve that tone. So they sound better than the old systems. They go further than their old systems. They're clearer, they're cleaner. They will automatically find the cleanest signal. They're license-free. You haven't got to pay for a wireless RF license. That's just one part of it. The second part is actually the units themselves and how easy they are to connect together. So again, with Shure glx-d Plus stuff, all you do, turn this bit on, turn that bit on, or turn your mic on and turn the receiver on, and they'll automatically link. I think the first time you do, you might have to press the link button on both of them. That's just the first time. Then you haven't got to do it again. As soon as you plug on both units, it'll automatically link them together and again, find the cleanest signal. As easy as that. You haven't got to scroll through loads of different RF frequencies and stuff and put your headset on and sit with a little Morse code beeper to try and find the cleanest signal. No, straight up plug in and play. It's ridiculous. Another upside of these guys is different variants that are available. So like I was saying, there's the headset microphones, the regular microphones, the lav mics, the guitar mics. The 6 Plus here, the glx-d 6 Plus, you can get it, well, you can't get the 6 Plus, but they're all called different 6, and this is the 6. You can get a regular tabletop version, you know, the ones that kind of like the traditional wireless receivers. You can get a rack mount version, which is the one that I use, but I haven't got this new fancy one, I've got the old one, a rack mount version, or the pedal tuner right here. So this is actually the receiver, it's pedal board friendly, and it's a tuner as well. The green light goes on, and I'm playing, press the button, mutes the signal like a traditional guitar tuner, and then I can see how sharp all of my strings are. It's ridiculous. What a great bit of tech. That's a very smart move. I hope someone got promoted for that. So those are the different variations available. Again, everything is linked in the description box down below, so you can check it all out at pmtonline.co.uk. Now, the last thing I want to touch upon about why the new wireless systems are awesome as opposed to the older ones, it's one of my favorite little bits. And that's the fact that they don't use your traditional batteries. These lovely things, whether it be the microphone or any of these kind of receiver little things in the Shure glx-d Plus systems, have rechargeable lithium ion batteries. So these little nifty guys right here, they either charge in this case by plugging into the receiver and then plugging a USB into the wall and charging it that way. In some of the tabletop and rack mount units, you can slide the little lithium ion battery into the receiver itself and charge it that way. Gone are the days of having gig bags and rucksacks and pockets and everything filled with AA batteries and 9-volt batteries. I hated that. Going through batteries was a right pain in the ass. They've got fast charging in them as well. On the glx-d Plus, you can charge, you can have up to 12 hours playing time for all those 12-hour gigs you do. Like, literally, I rarely charge mine. It's ridiculous. They don't draw a lot of power. And if you do want to, if something does happen and it does die, again, that fast charging, plug it straight in. A little bit of a jolt for like half an hour will get you a long way. But yeah, 12 hours battery time, all rechargeable lithium ion batteries. Gone are the days of battery graveyards in the bottom of gig bags. Thank you, Shure. As always, if you want to add onto anything that I spoke about in this video or put your own little 2 cents in about wireless systems, comment down below, but I think that might be it for me. I love wireless systems. If you're still using those pesky cables or an old wireless system, get yourself upgraded and preserve that precious guitar tone. But have a little wander up the stairs at the back of a gig when you're playing, or go into the crowd, have a bit of fun, climb the rafters, do whatever your heart desires. It's fantastic. Technology is awesome these days, and I'm here for it. Let me know what you think though. Comment down below, and if you like this video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to PMTVUK here on YouTube. Any more information, like I said, all the links are in the description box down below. We are playing music today on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and TikTok. I've been Dagan. I'll see you next time.